Our course has so far mainly focused on animals. In this chapter, we will talk about plants. After the conflict that dominated our narrative so far, we will conclude with the unique collaboration between plants and animals that has completely transformed our world. Plants and animals share our worlds since the dawn of our common eukaryotic history. While plants always provided the food and the oxygen to animals, this interaction did not usually result in significant modes of cooperation. And then, sometimes, around 160 million years ago, flowering plants appeared. Flowers are an amazing evolutionary invention that recruited animals to assist in plant reproduction in return for substantial benefits. This is arguably the biggest collaborative enterprise ever. We are here in Machane Yehuda Market in Jerusalem and marvel at the fruits of this partnership. Everything we see here and everything we eat stems ultimately from flowering plants. Plant evolution is a fascinating story based on many inventions. The first invention we will mention is photosynthesis, the use of solar energy to produce sugar. Photosynthesis yields all the energy used both by plants and by animals and leads also to the release of oxygen. In fact, it was invented already by prokaryotes. I hope you still remember what prokaryotes are, otherwise we will send you to refresh your memory in some boiling geysers in Yellowstone. The next progress we will discuss was the colonization of land by plants. This required a whole list of physiological inventions. In the second video, we will thus learn about moss and fern reproduction by spores and how they alternate between haploid and diploid phases. Seeds are a very important invention as they enable not only spatial dispersion, like spores, but also temporal dispersal. In a seed, a small plant embryo is packaged together with food sufficient for initial growth. We are in the arid Arava Valley in southern Israel, witnessing a rare bloom of flowers that takes place only in rare rainy years. Bringing male and female gametes together is one of the biggest challenges for plants that are rooted to their spot. We have already seen how sessile marine animals like corals solve this problem by releasing gametes into the water, as the male gametes, called pollen, have to get the female plants through air and not through water. Until the appearance of flower, wind was the only mode of transport for pollen, as we will discuss in the third video. Wind pollination is typical to conifers. It can also be found in certain flowers plants like palms that we will visit in the date orchards by the Dead Sea. The invention of flowers started the cooperation of plants and animals. The flower provides pollen and nectar that feed the pollinators in return to transport of pollen to the female reproductive organs. In the fourth video, we will discuss flowers and the three functional components: advertisement, reward, and reproductive organs. In the fifth video, we will talk about the interaction between flowering plants and the pollinators. And in the sixth video, we will get to know the pollinators themselves. In particular, insects like bees that are responsible for much of our food. In the seventh video, we will describe in detail the very special double fertilization pathway in flowers.
Animals play a crucial role not only in pollination, but also in seed dispersal, the plant version of parental care. As you see here, elephants are also important seed dispersers. Their digestion is not very efficient, so that seeds are not damaged. Some of them even have to pass the elephant digestive system in order to germinate. Here we see how a Clark's nutcracker in California is spreading pine seeds. He is harvesting seeds from the trees and buries them in dozens of locations in the forest. Some of them he will find again and eat, and some of them not, and they will germinate and grow into new trees. We have seen small and big fruits. These here of the sausage tree are among the biggest I know. If all you remember from this course is not to sit under this tree, this course might have very well saved your life.